Hello. In this video, we will isolate the effect of the irradiation of the paramecium, an organism under the microscope, by the three effects: infrared radiation, heat, and electromagnetic waves. In this case, we'll look at effect only on infrared radiation. As you'll see in a minute, the tests were conducted from 80 degrees F, or roughly 20 degrees centigrade, until 120 degrees F, or roughly 40 degrees centigrade, until the paramecium's essentially died by the overheating. And you'll see in this video actually what happens to paramecium. On the slide that's coming up in a second, there's also similar tests were done in the past by the Japanese researchers, by researchers in the US, and others are referenced. This slide is coming up in a minute, and then the test under the microscope will follow. So here's parameters. You might want to perhaps pause the video and make a copy of that, and then follow that. The test was set up with a microscope and a slide onto the microscope with a infrared radiation with a heat lamp, showing that initially paramecium are alive and well and active, and moving around at the 40 magnification. Now we want to 100x magnifications, and eventually we'll go to 400x magnification to show the size and activities and live and well situation with paramecium. The slide has been heated up by the infrared lamp, 120 watts, as you saw at the slide earlier. You may remind it to make a copy and then follow it. But basically, skipping through time here a little bit, we'll see now one of the parameciums is beginning to die because it's overheated by the infrared radiations. The other parameciums are not quite affected yet. Eventually, they'll be affected as well. At this point, only one is affected, and you can see as the paper by the Japanese authors. That was by Yoshiomi Tagaki, presented several years ago, show that blisters, as you can see, developing on the paramecium outer layer. Quite interesting video, actually, to see how it's almost ready to rupture, essentially self-destruct. The other ones are slowing down, but it's almost for a single-cell organism with essentially no intelligence. It's kind of amazing to see. You can almost construct the emotional story behind it. You can see how two parameciums almost inspect him to see how he's doing, so to speak. Obviously, these organisms, single cells, RNAs, DNAs, do not have the intelligence, but it kind of looks in the video quite amazing. You can see that after inability of this paramecium to finally die, so to speak, another one is actually approaching, and look what happens. At the moment when he just touches the spine of him, it will actually, right here, explode. You can see that's actually the final explosion and death of paramecium just happened. The next test, of course, will do similar effects by the electromagnetic radiations and by the heat, by different means. Ultraviolet radiations will be also used. But that will be reporting separate. I thought you'll enjoy to seeing this particular, although limited in scope, initial experiment. This is Lev Nelik, Pump Magazine. Any questions, just send me an email. The information was on the slide that was at the beginning of the video. Thank you.